Ship speed plays a very important role in various environmental as well as economic factors for the operator of the vessel. In this video, we will learn how ship speed is measured, what are the various factors affecting ship speed, and what are the different design speeds of cargo ships, and why it is important to know and regulate the ship speed. The unit for the ship speed is knots, which is equivalent to 1 nautical mile per hour. The ISO standard symbol for the knot is KN. Ancient seafarers used to measure the speed of the ship using a chip log. The chip log consisted of a log attached to a rope with a number of knots at equal intervals. The log was dropped in the water at the aft of the ship, and one sailor would watch the sand empty through a 30-second sand glass, while the others counted the number of knots that passed. The number of knots passed multiplied by the distance between the knots and divided by 30 seconds stated that 1 knot is equal to 1.852 km per hour, or 1 knot is equal to 1 nautical mile per hour. This is how knots originated and became a metric system to measure ship speed. A nautical mile is based on the circumference of the earth and is equal to 1 minute of latitude. Therefore, it is used in ships in charting and navigation. These days, most ships use GPS to measure the speed of the ship. The GPS system consists of a transmitter, receiver, and a satellite system. This is the most accurate method of measuring the speed of the vessel. Multiple satellites constantly orbiting the Earth send radio signals, which are received by the receiver fitted onboard ships. After receiving signals from different satellites, the receiver can calculate its position based on the delay in receiving the signal from different satellites, as they are at a distance from each other. The internal electronics track that position in time and calculates the ship speed. Other methods of measuring speed are using Doppler shift and correlation velocity log, or CVL. Doppler shifts uses the Doppler effect, which is the relative change in frequency of a wave when the source and the observer are in relative motion. The sound pulse generated by the ship's motion is reflected off the ocean floor, and the same is measured by sonar instruments on a ship. The CVL uses a combination of multiple transmitters and receivers. Being one of the most expensive methods of measuring speed, correlation is generated between signals from different transmitters at different locations, and the speed of the ship is thus calculated. If we compare a seagoing ship with other transport medium in terms of power, ships are fitted with massive powerful engines. A mega container ship engine generates power between 80,000 to 1,09,000 horsepower. The biggest marine engine ever made is the Wärtsilä Sulzer RTA-96C, which generates a whopping 109,000 horsepower and is fitted in IMA Maersk, one of the world's largest ships. The engine of the most successful commercial airplane, Boeing 747, can generate power of up to 90,000 horsepower with one engine. Big trailer truck engine can generate power between 300 to 600 horsepower. And normal hatchback car engines are available in 100 to 130 horsepower range. However, when we compare the graph of this transportation modes in terms of speed, we will see different visuals. The ships tend to be the slowest among all, even after running with a powerful engine. To understand the reason behind the ship's low speed, we first need to understand two important concepts: the power to weight ratio and the ship resistance. It is used as a measurement of performance of a ship as a whole, with the engine's power output being divided by the weight of the ship to give a metric that is independent of the vessel's size. In simple terms, the engine has to overcome the total weight of the ship, including that of cargo and passengers on board, to move the ship ahead. For a car engine of 100 horsepower, it needs to overcome the weight of the car, which is around 1000 kg. However, for a ship engine of 90,000 horsepower, it needs to overcome the massive weight of the ship and the cargo, which can be in the range of 150,000 to 180,000 tons. Apart from the load the engine needs, the ship also needs to overcome different types of resistance. For land transportation, a vehicle moves on four wheels on a tar road, which offers resistance against the motion of the vehicle. However, the contact areas of the tires are very small, and hence the resistance acting on the tires is easily overcome by the engine power. When it comes to ship, the large part of the enormous engine hull is inside water, which resists the motion of the ship. The motion of a ship through water requires energy to overcome this resistance, that is, the force working against the movement. When the ship is sailing through calm water, it faces three types of opposing resistance: frictional resistance, residual resistance, and air resistance. The frictional resistance works on the wetted surface of the ship, that is, the hull part contacting the waters. This is the biggest factor among the three types of resistance and can take up to 60 to 80% of the total resistance for ships such as bulkers and tankers, which are technically low-speed ships. For ships such as container, RORO ships, passenger ships, etc., which are higher-speed ships, the frictional resistance comprises of 40 to 60% of the total resistance. The residual resistance comes into play when the ship generates waves by losing its energy. As the ship cuts through the water, the hull loses its energy in developing pressure to generate wave, and the loss can be up to 10 to 30% for low speed ship and 40 to 65% for high speed commercial ships. The air resistance plays a small role among the three. However, it can be significant if a loaded ship is heading against the wind. Various factors affecting ship speed. Apart from the previously mentioned reasoning on ship resistance, the speed of a ship depends on various factors such as displacement of the vessel. Displacement of the ship is the amount of water displaced by the ship to get accommodated in the water to float. For an empty ship which has no cargo loaded, displacement is less and hence the draft will be less. There is less resistance as the lesser surface of the hull is in contact with water, and as there is not much load on the main engine, it gives more speed at less power. In simple terms, the more cargo the ship carries, the more will be the displacement and less will be the ship speed if the hull, propeller and rudder are not optimized. Sea weather condition. If the sea state is rough and the ship is heading against the tide, the engine will have to work harder to overcome the force, and the overall load will increase to maintain the speed. If the engine is not able to maintain the load, the ship speed will decrease. Condition of the hull and the propeller. Hull condition plays a vital role in maintaining the ship speed. A clean hull with appropriate paint will have less resistance as compared to a fouled hull. Operational condition of the main engine. The main engine is the reason behind the ship sailing in the seas. If it is not maintained properly or efficiently run, it will not produce the required speed for the vessel. importance of regulating ship speed. At the design level, bigger container ships with less speed are being constructed to obtain less CO2 emissions per container. At the operational level, the practice of slow steaming, that is, reducing speed of the ship as a response to depressed market conditions and higher fuel prices, is being used in almost all commercial shipping sectors. In slow steaming, a container ship travels at a speed of around 12 to 19 knots instead of the usual 20 to 24 knots. This results in reduction of engine power and fuel consumption. This is because the correlation between the speed and shaft power is not linear but cubic. If you have any questions or suggestions, please drop your comments below and we'll get back to you at the earliest. If you like this video, please subscribe to the Marine Insight channel and press the bell icon to get notified when we post such amazing videos. Please like, comment and share this video, and do not forget to subscribe to our channel.